Hey, what's going on? This is Wayne here, and we are at the Yankee convention. I am with Dan from HPC, and we are checking out the Quicksilver machine. Go ahead and tell us a little bit about this.
Okay, so this is the newest machine in our computerized code line, and I'll just show you through some of the features that we have on here. So when you boot up the machine, this is the first screen that you'll see. So favorites is a really neat feature because if you go through and you cut the same key over and over again, there's actually a spot in that page where you can add that key to your favorites. So rather than keep going through all the menus over and over again, you can just go to your favorites list, pick it up, enter your bidding, load your key, and cut right from there.
It makes it faster.
A lot faster. And that's why we want to really promote the name. When we call it Quicksilver, it really is that quick. And, you know, one of the other features, too, which I'll show you, is just how fast you can really cut a key.
Okay.
So next, we have our setup menu here. We have a calibration function so that if you have this machine in your truck or on the bench, something falls on it, you hit a pothole, knock it out of calibration. The machine comes with a calibration key that you'll load into the jaw. The cutter will touch off on the shoulder, the middle of the key, and the tip of the key. And it'll restore the machine back to factory specs.
Nice. So you don't have to worry about mechanically calibrating it or sending it back in.
Nope. And the calibration process is very quick. It's a few minutes total, and it'll bring it right back to factory spec.
Okay.
Another feature that I like to show you in the setup here is card setup. So if you have our 1200 CMB machine, and you find that, you know, let's say you're cutting Schlage or Quickset, and you find that a cut could be too shallow or too deep, you can mic it off and, you know, keep that measurement. You can add it to that card and permanently save it to the card. So if you're cutting off of that Schlage and you find that it's a little too deep, you can put that measurement in there and save it permanently, so you'll never have to do it over and over again.
Perfect.
Okay, so finally we'll go to our cut key menus here. So you see the four selections here. We got code, card, copy, and key software. So you can look up by code in here. This actually has our code source software loaded into it, so it's a vast database of codes. So you can just type in your code number and go from there. Card, I'll come back to that next. But copy, this machine also copies a cut key. So you see here we have the selections from auto, commercial, residential, your favorites. So you'll just load a cut key in here. The cutter will rotate slowly towards each cut, and it'll display the bidding from there. All you'll have to do after that is unload your key, put in your blank, and you're good to go. You'll cut right from there.
Awesome.
And then key software here, you can actually, if you have our master key program, Master King, you can create your master system on your PC, and then you can connect the machine to your PC via USB, which is right here on the side of our machine.
Oh, wow.
So you can create your master system, download it to the machine, and start cutting your keys that much faster for your master system. So we'll go into the card setup here. And just like with the copy function, it's listed by auto, commercial, residential, your favorites. If you have an ITL machine or a Silica machine and you're used to those numbers to look up, you can select those and punch that number in. Or if you have our 1200 CMB, you can look up the card by the blitz function.
Okay.
But for this demonstration, I'll go through DSD. So I have a Schlage key. So we know the DSD number for Schlage is 60. So right here, I punch in 60, it comes up with Schlage. You'll see the three options here. I got cut key, view card, I can modify, or I can add it to my favorites page right here. So I'll add it to my favorites here, or I can remove it as well. And when you click on view card, you can see that all the information that's listed, the ITL number, the Silica number, the CMB number, your max, all that good stuff.
Nice.
So we'll go into cut key. So here, I'm just gonna punch in our biddings here. I'm gonna say cut. The next screen will show you where you gauge the key off of. As you know, on a Schlage, you're gonna gauge off of the shoulder. Just gonna hit next. And this screen right here is going to show you the jaw side, how you're gauging it, the cut profile, and the feed rate. So the jaw side, we actually have two sides on this. The A side is going to be mostly for your residential and commercial keys, whereas your B side will be for automotive.
Okay.
So we're going to stick with A on this, obviously. Shoulder gauge for Schlage. The cut profile here, we'll stick with the plunge profile. But for the demonstration in this video, I'll actually increase the cut speed on this. And I'm going to put it to our fastest speed, which would be zero.
Okay.
So just before we load the key and just to talk about some other features here, the motor here on this machine is based off of the design on our Blitz machine, which is tried and true. So we've replicated that motor here. We've also installed a timing belt on here. You can see it's got grooves in the belt, so that will prevent any kind of slippage.
Yeah.
So it's rock solid. And then right here, we have a single-sided cutter. This is the only cutter that you'll use with this machine. And the only time that you'll take that cutter off is when you need to replace it.
Because the machine is actually going to make the longer cuts if it's a quick set, or the narrower ones if it's a sergeant.
Absolutely. All right, so now that being said, let's load up our key here. So load the key in like that. The shoulder gauge flips up from the bottom there. And then it's very important. I always tell everybody to just make sure that you flip your shoulder gauge down. We don't, unfortunately, have a switch on there. Okay. So the machine will run if it's up.
Okay.
Okay. So now that I've done that, let's just go ahead. We'll start to cut the key. And then you can see how fast this will cut.
So about 535. About 5 seconds of actual cutting.
So just like that, the key is cut. So actually, now we have a couple options here on the screen. You can tap to cut another key. You don't have to go through any of the menus again. All you'll literally have to do is just load the key again and tap that check mark. It'll go again.
Nice.
Or you can cut new key, and you can just, it'll bring you back to the same menu where we put in the biddings. You can change your bidding from there.
Yep.
And then new cards. So let's say now you want to cut a quick set. You can look up that quick set card and start all over again.
All right, perfect. Brush it up.
And there we go.
Now we're ready to go.
We're ready to go.
Very cool. All right, that's really easy, really fast, really nice. Thanks, Dan.
Thank you, Wayne.